So, Dr. Rose, you had a couple of points in your presentation about access to finance and the lack thereof, and also the presence of these shadow investors, right? And also incentives for legalization. With access to finance, you know, it would benefit both. It would benefit in a lot of ways if we really seriously look at this issue. We could help move away from mercury technologies by, again, being able to afford better things, which pay for themselves very quickly. There's an amazing ROI on this stuff, and I encourage any organization working in mining to start really emphasizing the business case of these investments, because you can get huge efficiency gains by abandoning mercury. And if we start reaching out to more banks, guaranteeing loans at a lower rate, so wouldn't it be interesting for the World Bank or others to guarantee loans made by banks? So instead of 40, 50% interest that I've heard of, it could be something much more reasonable, like under 20. I think there's some interesting brainstorming we can do if we have the right people in the room to really think about this access to finance and really opening up the wealth, that locked up wealth of Ghana right now. One thing that's important to think about is if someone is illegal outside the law, they can't get a bank loan. So you're forcing them in some ways to go to other folks. But if they are legal, they can use that title to start getting other things to become part of the banking system if we engage our banks correctly and help them think about proof points to offer or to ask for miners. So on the incentives for legalization, you know, some of the best practice is lowering the registration fees, the license fees. Having a quick turnaround for the application, so people aren't waiting months or years to get registered. But there's also some kind of hidden tricks. So miners often like to be paid quickly and in cash. So if you can create a system whereby people could get, you know, can get those things, that's one thing you can add to your honeypot. You can offer things like government-backed loans for better equipment. You could offer things like good health insurance. They're trying that in Mongolia. There's a number of things that, you know, you can work out in focus groups, you know, with folks who are legal and illegal that might, again, make them more interested in becoming legal if it's affordable, accessible, and there's some incentives. So again, it's a carrot and stick model. You can't just have a stick, you have to have the carrots too.